Do you guys ever just sit at your computer, kind of bored and not knowing what to do? So you look through your list of games and you realize that you don't really feel like playing any of them. Inevitably, you pick the easiest one, probably Skyrim. You play it for a few minutes and you hit Alt F4, and then you realize that you're completely burnt out on games. You might want to try a book, and I know some good books which heavily feature necromancy. I'll begin with the Haunted Lands trilogy by Richard Lee Byers. These are three books: Unclean, Undead, and Unholy, and they all take place in the Forgotten Realms universe. For those who don't know, this is a fantasy setting for Dungeons and Dragons. It's also the setting for at least a dozen games, most notably Baldur's Gate and Neverwinter Nights. The books are about an undead invasion against the country of Thay in Eastern Faerun, which is home to the infamous Red Wizards. Thay is a magocracy, and its rulers are the Zolkirs. Every school of magic has its own Zolkir. The powerful Lich, Zaztam, is the Zolkir of Necromancy. He's a central character and heavily involved in the plot. Parts of the books are also written from his perspective. All kinds of wonderful, different undead appear in the books, and the trilogy is definitely some of the best necromancy fiction I've had the pleasure of reading. I've read a lot of Forgotten Realms novels, and Richard Lee Byers has stuck in my mind as one of the better authors. He's also the author of Disillusion, the first book in the War of the Spider Queen series. The Old Kingdom is a series of books by Garth Nix. It's set in a universe where two worlds coexist beside each other. In the north, you have the Old Kingdom, a land of magic. In the south, you have a more mundane world with a human civilization similar to our own, with technology, guns, cars, etc. The magic of the north doesn't work well in the south, and technology begins to fail if it's taken north, so the two worlds are kind of kept apart in this way. Evil necromancers are the antagonists of the books, and the protagonists are the Abhorsens. The Abhorsens are considered to be the only good necromancers and are entrusted to defend the Old Kingdom and the rest of humanity from the evil necromancers. The magic system in this setting is interesting. It's separated into two kinds of magic: charter magic and free magic. Charter magic is considered safe and official, while free magic is not well understood and dangerous. Most of the evil mages and necromancers are free magic users. I like to think of the charter as being the internet, while free magic is like the deep web. It's a similar kind of difference. Part of free magic is necromancy, and it's done using sounds. It's possible to control people's souls and the undead using whistling or clapping, but to do it properly, an instrument is needed. In the books, this is done using a set of differently sized bells. Each bell has a different effect, and some bells are incredibly dangerous, capable of backfiring on a clumsy necromancer who uses them incorrectly. I haven't finished reading this series yet. I've only read the first two books, Sabriel and Lirael, and I haven't started an Abhorsen yet. I think these books are pretty good, and they show necromancy from the perspective of good necromancers fighting against evil necromancers, which is a refreshing look at the subject. There's a lesser-known gem that I only recently found out about myself, and it's called Zothique. It's a collection of short stories written by Clark Ashton Smith about a fictional future continent on Earth called Zothique, which rose out of the seas after the continents of our timeline have long since sunken. Clark Ashton Smith was writing about Zothique at around the same time H.P. Lovecraft and Robert E. Howard were writing their stories. He even contributed his stories to the same Weird Tales magazine that Lovecraft and Howard did, which is also why they're in the short story format. I haven't finished reading all of the Zothique stories, but of the ones I've read so far, all of them have featured necromancers and necromancy. The world of Zothique is a kind of dark fantasy world, and it's pretty bleak. Smith's writing style is of that older, more descriptive and detached style that you might expect from a Weird Tales story. If you like Howard and Lovecraft, you'll probably also love Clark Ashton Smith's Zothique. Unfortunately, as far as I can tell, Zothique is out of print. You can buy the paperback from the 1970s, secondhand, for hundreds of dollars, or you can find the stories online in PDF form. While we're on the topic of weird tales stories, I'd like to recommend both H.P. Lovecraft and Robert E. Howard for short stories involving necromancy. Howard's stories don't always feature magic, but when magic occurs, it tends to be of the softer kind. There's rarely fireball throwing or very flashy displays of magic. Magic is mostly about demon summoning, curses, and dark rituals, as well as coercion. The Scarlet Citadel short story features a surprisingly powerful necromancer called Pelias. Pelias raises the dead in a very direct and unambiguous way. And what I mean by that is that the magic is more of what we would expect from a modern game or something, not the soft kind of magic we're used to with Howard. The story is also one of the rare stories where a sorcerer is a protagonist helping Conan rather than an antagonist which Conan is fighting against. Lovecraft has a few stories of necromancy, but the story where it's most heavily featured would be in Herbert West's Reanimator. In this short story, a mad scientist and his assistant are researching ways to bring corpses back to life by injecting a concoction into their veins. The necromancy in Herbert West's Reanimator is very much of the scientific kind. So if you like it, then you'll probably also like Frankenstein. Frankenstein is of course a famous book, and I shouldn't have to tell you much about it, but in case you're unaware, Frankenstein is all about a scientist who assembles the creature from parts of dead people and brings it back to life. This list is unfortunately rather short, but these are the only novels and short stories I know of that feature necromancy. I hope I haven't forgotten any. In the future I'll do another video and talk about more books of necromancy if I find them. Thanks for watching. I hope these books will help keep you entertained. By the way, if you're wondering why I haven't made a video in a while, it's just because I've been rather busy lately. I also haven't been much in the mood for playing games or making videos. I've also just been having a good time reading books instead of playing games. I've been a bit annoyed of games recently. They're a bit of work, you know, setting up all the mods, getting invested, then the game crashes, then you get pissed off because you can't enjoy the game anymore because of stupid shit like that. This gets on your nerves, man. Fortunately, a book will not crash on you. And it won't corrupt your save files either, I promise. And it also helps you fall asleep at night. Stay tuned for more videos on necromancy games, books, and mods.